So now let's start the textbook exercise. Page number 133, the statement problems. So you saw the activity. Statement problems are nothing but the story problems. So now imagine or think we are going to read a story. So let's read the first story. Anil had 48 marbles. He lost 32 marbles. How many marbles are left with him? So the story is, there is a boy Anil. Okay, once upon a time there was a boy called Anil and he had 48 marbles. Suddenly one day he lost 32 marbles. So now how many marbles do Anil have? So he had 48, now he lost 32, right? So how much he has? So that is what we have to find now. So how to write that in the classwork? Children, this is not the classwork, you are not going to write it. I am just showing it for explanation. So first, main statement problems. So Anil, so we have to write the story here. Like, these are story problems, no? So we have to first write the story and then do subtraction. We should not do directly. So what is the story telling us? 48, he has 48 what? 48 is the marbles he already had, no? So you will write, Anil had 48 marbles, right? So 48 marbles. So you should write this story in a statement like, number of marbles he had. So this is a story, but you should not write as it is. I should always take the number on my right side here. Okay, 48. What is this 48? This is the number of marbles Anil had. So I should write, what is this number telling me also? 48 is number of marbles Anil had. Next number is 32 in the question. So what is this 32? This is also a number of marbles which he lost. So you'll write, number, short form of number is NO, number of marbles he lost. So like this you should write. And now we have to subtract, no, because it's lost, it's gone. So you should do subtraction. So how much is remaining? If you see this word remaining, left, all these words tells you that you should do subtraction. So you have left here, so we should do subtraction. Okay, so let's do subtraction. 8 minus 2. Open 8 fingers, close 2. You get 6. 4 minus 3 is 1. So what is this 16? This is the number of marbles which is left with Anil, no? So that I should write here. Number of marbles left is equal to 16. So Anil, how many marbles he has now? He has 16 marbles. So this was the first story. So let's go for the second story now. In a basket there are 68 fruits. Okay, so once upon a time there was a small fruit shop. In one basket they had 68 fruits. In that 68 fruits, 40 of them were apples and the rest were oranges. So how many oranges they have? It's not given here. That is what we should find here in this story. Okay, now let's write the story in the book. So now story writing doesn't mean we have to write all here. What is the first number given in this book? 68. So 68 is the first number. And what is this number? This number is telling me the total fruits in the basket. So I should write that here. This is 68 is number of fruits in basket. Next, what is the number given? 40. 40. What is this 40 telling me? This 40 is nothing but it is the number of apples in the basket. So I'll write number of apples. Now, what should you do? How many oranges are there in the basket? So you should find oranges. How will you find oranges? By subtracting the number of apples, because in the basket you have only two fruits. One is apple, one is oranges. Apple they have given. Now let's take off all the apples. Then you will get only oranges number. Okay. So you have to subtract apple number from the fruits number. Let's subtract. 8 minus 0 is 8 only. 6 minus 4, you get 2. So I got my answer. 28 oranges are there in the basket. So how will you write here? 28 is nothing but number of oranges. Number of oranges is 28. So similarly, you can try the other three sums. Okay, you have four sums. So let me do one more sum for you. Here I will take the last sum here. Arvind scored 88 marks in maths examination. Raju scored 73 marks in the same examination. How many more marks did Arvind score than Raju in the exam? So this is very important that you understand the story. Once upon a time, in a school, there were two best friends called Arvind and Raju. Arvind scored 88 in maths, Raju scored 73 in maths. So who scored more here? Arvind only, because 88 is more than 73, right? Yes, Arvind scored 88 marks. He is the highest. But how much marks did he score more than Raju? That is the question here. That is what we have to find. For that, if you do subtraction, you will know how much did Arvind score more than Raju. So let's try that now. So last sum, first what is the number given? 88. What is this 88? It is the marks of Arvind. So we'll write marks scored by Anirudh. It's Anirudh, right? Yes, Arvind. Arvind. It's 88. Next is 73. So what is the 73 telling me? It is marks scored by Raju. Marks scored by Raju. Now if I subtract, what is the answer I will get? How much did Arvind score more than Raju, right? So I will get marks Arvind scored more than Raju. Children, if you see, I stopped it here only. I am not continuing writing because I should do working here. In the next line only I can write. If I write and continue here, I can't write the answer. So I should not continue here. Be careful. Okay. So now, what is the marks scored by Arvind more than Raju? So let's subtract. 8 minus 3. Open 8 fingers, close 3 fingers. You get 5. 8 minus 7 is 1. So Arvind scored 15 marks more than Raju. So other 3 I want you to try and tell me the answers in the interactive class. Any doubts will get clarified in the interactive session. Thank you. Bye.